Queen Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network. Put your head right.
Today, I am announcing again that I'm running for the President of these United States of America.
We still believe.
Dr. Wilson,
we'll
take a couple
of
three questions.
Good morning. Carl West, TBT News Service. I have two questions briefly. One, will you commit to the battle of other Democrats running for the President of the United States for the duration? And two, what would you say to the primarily black Chicago elite who have already thrown their hand behind Hillary Clinton? How would you bring some of them back on board with you, or on board with you?
Mm-hmm. Well, let's put it this way. I believe that this is a free country, and I'm willing to work hard to earn the respect and the vote of all citizens. I'm running for all citizens of America, understanding where I come from. You know, I understand the problems and the battle that is out there. I understand the different things. These people have been in office for a long time, the running for president today, all right? And we don't ever see them in our neighborhood until we get ready to meet.
All right, you know? Yes. Come on.
But I'm in the neighborhood, and I will remain in the neighborhood even as I become your next president. I think that if they're going to vote for our other candidate, God bless him, because I am running on this strictly by faith and from the people.
All right. All right.
Thank you. So in the race for mayor, you had 10% of the vote, 50,000 people chose you to run for mayor. In light of that, that's your first foray right into running for office. Why aim for president? Why not alderman or governor or something? More local.
Well, see, why not? America been good to me.
Yes.
I wasn't brought here to start at the bottom. I was brought here because of my faith and belief in that as many people that I can help as possible while I'm still here. You know, Lord have blessed me to be here. I would reach for that. You know, we didn't lose the mayor because we brought a lot of issues to the forefront. We won't lose this.
That's right.
We are doing the people's choice. I'm not in this here to be a lobbyist afterward.
Well, right, sir.
I'm not in here to make money for myself. I'm not in here to show favor to any particular group or organization. I am truly in this here to help the people of America.
Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network. Put your head right.
What's your name?
Jane.
Jane, you are so pretty, girl.
Thank you.
Make us four finger sisters look good. So why are you here today? What brought you here?
Actually, I come out here a lot for book signings, but okay. I really liked her book. I read it. It was encouraging or whatever.
You read it already?
Yeah, I got it a few weeks ago. So.
Okay. Have you read Shalom's books, Inspirational Conversations, 365 Days of Promise? Comes on Troy Tyler every day at 10:45.
Was Elder Robinson?
Yeah.
Yeah, I sure have.
That?
Yeah, it's on my bookshelf. Yeah.
Is it really? Yeah. Where'd you get it from?
Afrocentric.
Good for you. I'm going to introduce you to her when we get in here, okay?
Right.
Yeah, okay. Let's come on in. We're going in the book.
We're going to see Monique. Us big girls, you know, we got our own fan club.
By the way, have you ever met Zelda? Do you know who she is?
No, I've never met her.
You're talking to her.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Are you special conversation with
Zelda? Yeah, you see, I got my book, girl.
Let me get a shake hand.
Hey, come on, sister.
Okay.
We're giving us fun, girl.
The thing about interfaith is that they allowed me to heal.
Imagine if you were being discharged from the hospital to the street, what would happen to you? You would either end up dead or back into the hospital system. Interfaith House is a recuperative center for those individuals who are coming out of the hospital system. So instead of recovering on the streets, they can recover here at Interfaith House. We provide services so they can heal, they can rebuild their lives, they can renew their spirits to get to the next level.
The face of homelessness isn't what you necessarily would think. There are many people that are homeless that have careers, that have families, master's degrees, doctorate degrees. We don't have any idea how many people are just one paycheck away, one day away from being homeless.
Yeah, I have 20 years in the mechanics business. And then one day I had a seizure. I had a seizure, woke up in a back of an ambulance, and I was on my way to Metro South in Blue Island. After I was discharged from the hospital, it's a little over a month later, so you're evicted and all your stuff's gone. It can just happen to anybody anytime out of the blue.
Primary services that Interfaith House provides is a safe place to heal, food and shelter, social services, medical services, so that whenever they leave Interfaith House, they're not going back out on the streets. Instead, they're rejoining society again. We don't discharge unless they're well and they have stable housing. It's amazing to see somebody that when they walked in the doors, they didn't have a place to live and they had no hope at all. And when they walk out of the doors here, they have their life back. There's no other organization of its kind in the state of Illinois.
The staff is fantastic. You could say that each one of them is the glue of this place because they just have a tendency to care.
On any given night, there's about 600,000 individuals in the U.S. that are homeless. There are homeless people who are ill and injured on the street. That's every day. They have no place to go. There is a great need for this place.
I do have hope. You know, right now, today, at least I'm smiling. You know, I am smiling, so, and I'm doing things that I thought I'd never do.
I don't know where I would be at if I didn't have Interfaith. Is there like an angel watching over you? I put down my deposit and my first month's rent. I'm leaving Tuesday, April 1st, and that's gonna start my new life after Interfaith.
Join the Higher Learning Network at our new time, Tuesdays at 6 p.m. on Channel 19.
Zelda Robinson from the Higher Learning Network. With the current situation with education, what will make your plan for forgiveness of the student loan and putting prayer back in school, what will make a difference in that as opposed to what President Obama is currently doing?
Well, the difference is that I understand education and I value it. We was from down south, and we didn't have the opportunity to get a good education. You know, I understand the need, okay, by me being shut out, you know, under certain circumstances. We would make sure that we push that forward to make sure it happened. We have the dollars, you know. We shouldn't be fighting, spending like, I think about $12 to $13 billion a day on wars overseas. That's how they got to stop. This got to come.
Right. Come on.
Yeah, all right.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
That's how we will stop it. That the president has control of. You know, so we would make that happen and make sure that every child, regardless of what neighborhood color you are, that it will come home. The difference is this here. It is that I'm from the neighborhood, of the neighborhood, and never left the neighborhood, and will always remain in the neighborhood.
All right.
And will you take a salary?
I would take a salary, but I would give it away to our churches.
Yes, sir.
Our community.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Strasburg.
Join the Higher Learning Network at our new time, Tuesdays at 6 p.m. on Channel 19.
Hi, my name is State Senator Ricky Hendon, and you're watching the Higher Learning Network.
Jane.
Jane, you are so pretty good.
Thank
Make
you.
Us four-finger sisters look good.
So why are you here today? What brought you here?
Actually, I come out here a lot for book signings, but okay. I really liked her book. I read it. It was encouraging and whatever.
You read it already?
Yeah, I got it a few weeks ago. So.
Okay. Have you read Shalomith's books, Inspirational Conversations, 365 Days from Promise? Comes on Troy Tyler every day at 10:45.
Was Elder Robinson?
Yeah,
I sure have.
That?
Yeah, it's
good
on my bookshelf. Yeah,
is it? Where'd you get it from?
Afrocentric Downtown.
Good for you. Uh-huh. I'm going to introduce you to her when we get in here, okay?
Right.
Yeah, okay. So let's come on in. We're going in the book.
We're going to see Monique. Us big girls, you know, we got our own fan club.
By the way, have you ever met Zelda? Do you know who she is?
No, I've never met her.
You're talking to her.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
I just had a special conversation with
Zelda. You see, I got my book, girl.
Let me get a shake of hand.
We're standing here at the presidential launching of Dr. Willie Wilson for the President of the United States for 2016. And I'm standing here with his former campaign manager, Dr. Gregory Livingston. Dr. Livingston, how are you participating in the election this year, the presidential bid?
Well, with this campaign, I worked as campaign manager for the mayoral bid. And this one, I'm the chief of staff, and he and I working side by side to make everything happen.
What did he tell you and to make you believe that he has a chance of winning this election when he just lost the former mayoral election?
Well, one of the ways I can address that is that everybody said that Hillary was the shoo-in. Everybody said that nobody had a chance. And so now we've had a president that wasn't Hillary for the past 8 years because he didn't listen to everybody, he listened to his heart. So I listened to Dr. Wilson because his whole life is about following his heart. And I think that's important. And so he's been doing pretty good following his heart so far. So I said, hey, let's go, let's do this.
Was there any hesitation when he first told you? Because we just interviewed Ricky Hinton, Senator Ricky Hinton, and he told him he was crazy.
Oh, there was hesitation from everybody except him. Except Dr. Wilson, you know, because when an individual decides to do something like this, you really have to have it deep down inside you because you can't be wavering. And so he's stepped out with absolute confidence. I mean, most of our concerns were about protecting him, if you will, you know, because it's not easy to be, and let's be honest, to be a black man, an African American, to run for this particular office. I mean, I believe President Obama has received more death threats probably than all the other presidents together, you know. So it's a real situation, but Dr. Wilson is an individual that has been able to overcome adversity and to navigate all kind of negative things throughout his life and the mayoral campaign as well. So this presidential bid here, this campaign, it won't be anything new to him in terms of dealing with negativity. It's just the scope of it will be a lot greater.
On a closing comment, what would you say to viewers who are watching this show who says they just don't know?
I would tell them to really to listen to what the man has to say, listen to his ideas, give him a chance. Don't confuse a great public speaker with a great person.
And you heard it here first, right here on the Higher Learning Network. And thank you for watching.
Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network.
Put your hand right.
The thing about interfaith is that they allowed me to heal.
Imagine if you were being discharged from the hospital to the street, what would happen to you? You would either end up dead or back into the hospital system. Interfaith House is a recuperative center for those individuals who are coming out of the hospital system. So instead of recovering on the streets, they can recover here at Interfaith House. We provide services so they can heal, they can rebuild their lives, they can renew their spirits to get to the next level.
The face of homelessness isn't what you necessarily would think. There are many people that are homeless that have careers, that have families, master's degrees, doctorate degrees. We don't have any idea how many people are just one paycheck away, one day away from being homeless.
Yeah, I have 20 years in the mechanics business. And then one day I had a seizure. I had a seizure, woke up in a back of an ambulance, and I was on my way to Metro South in Blue Island. After I was discharged from the hospital, it's a little over a month later, so you're evicted and all your stuff's gone. It can just happen to anybody anytime out of the blue.
Primary services that Interfaith House provides is a safe place to heal, food and shelter, social services, medical services, so that whenever they leave Interfaith House, they're not going back out on the streets. Instead, they're rejoining society again. We don't discharge unless they're well and they have stable housing. It's amazing to see somebody that when they walked in the doors, they didn't have a place to live and they had no hope at all. And when they walk out of the doors here, they have their life back. There's no other organization of its kind in the state of Illinois.
The staff is fantastic. You could say that each one of them is the glue of this place because they just have a tendency to care.
On any given night, there's about 600,000 individuals in the U.S. that are homeless. There are homeless people who are ill and injured on the street. That's every day. They have no place to go. There is a great need for this place.
I do have hope. You know, right now today, at least I'm smiling. You know, I am smiling. So, and I'm doing things that I thought I'd never do.
I don't know where I would be at if I didn't have interfaith. Is there like an angel watching over you? I put down my deposit and my first month's rent. I'm leaving Tuesday, April 1st, and that's gonna start my new life after interfaith.
Mr. Wilson, what would you do about Boko Haram and the violence that he's perpetrating on innocent young girls?
Well, right now, as I said before, we have a global economy, of course, and America is all around the world. First, we have to gotta take your home first.
Yes, sir.
You know,
right.
I think that's been one of the problems with America. We're running over the world, trying to take care of the world when we got the same problem here at home.
All right.
So I'm committed to home first.
Yes.
Before we can go beyond home. And that would be my stand. And I understand the need, but we just cannot spread ourselves in countries that we don't have any interest in. And when America is war within itself, you know, we have people here are private, you know. So we would have to start at home first. I am the people choice for president. I can guarantee you that because I would speak that language.
All right.
Yay!
Join the Higher Learning Network at our new time, Tuesdays at 6 p.m. on Channel 19.
My name is Gregory Livingston, and I'm the Chief of Staff for the Willie Wilson for President campaign, and you're watching the Higher Learning Network.
We're here live at the press conference, the U.S. presidential press conference for Dr. Willie Wilson, and I'm standing here by Chicago's very own Mr. Ricker Hinton, former Senator Ricky Hinton. Tell us how you became involved with this presidential campaign and where do you see it going?
Well, Dr. Wilson called me and told me he was interested in a run. I told him he was crazy. And you got to be crazy to get into this mess. We're in a mess. The country's in a mess. But he convinced me with his heart. When I was convinced that he was sincere about it, I said, okay, I'll do everything I can. You know, I think people who put themselves out there should be sincere. And because I felt that he was truly sincere and in it all the way, I decided to give him all the help I can give him.
What do you think is the likelihood of his chances of winning an unknown?
I think it's pretty good because American people, if you poll after poll, they're tired of the career politicians. People have been in office 20, 30 years and been in Washington. Washington is clearly dysfunctional. So they want something new and a fresh face. And I think that Dr. Wilson brings to the Democratic primary what Ben Carson brings to the Republican primary. Only the difference is Carson won't talk about our issues and Dr. Wilson will. So, like you said, even in America, we did not lose because we brought up issues that otherwise were not going to be discussed. Hillary Clinton, I read, she's not discussing issues affecting Detroit, Chicago, Baltimore, Ferguson. Sanders, he hasn't mentioned a word. O'Malley, I heard his speech, he didn't mention a word. So at least Dr. Wilson will bring up issues that are pertinent to our people. And he's the anti-tax and anti-war Democrat. I think we have a great chance.
I think we have a great chance as well. But what do you say to the naysayer who's watching what will be going on in the next year as he runs and there are these issues that are following him that no one prior to him has been able to make a difference?
Well, it's clear if you look at President Obama, he's been in there 6 years. I like President Obama, but if you look in our communities, you say, has it worked or not? Some people, you know, say some things work, but we're still in foreclosure. We're still unemployed. We're still victims of police violence at a disproportionate level. So to those people who say Dr. Wilson is not the right candidate, I say, who? Well, who? Why don't you do it? You get out there. You know, they want to criticize Dr. Wilson because he did not get a college degree. But 11 presidents in the United States of America did not get a college degree. Mm. So we're going to give it our best, talk straight to the people, and keep it real, and let the voters decide.
And what will be the turning point in this election, do you think?
I believe the turning point in this election will be at the Democratic convention. I think it's going to go to the convention. I believe that all the candidates, if you look at the Republican candidates, nobody's over 17%. Hillary was at 60%, but she's fading pretty fast. So I believe it's going to go to the convention, and we'll be part of that platform.
Okay.
I think that's what it'll tell
you. Oh, I'm stepping on somebody's cord here. Sorry about that. Camera guys got to do their work. What? Look into that camera and tell the world. I'm not going to say just the Chicagoan, but the world. Why? For those who don't know Dr. Willie Wilson, we know him because we live in this community for 30 years plus. He's been helping people of all colors to do amazing things. Look into the camera and tell the person why they should go for that.
Dr. Willie Wilson will talk straight. He will not lie to you. He is what he is. What you see is what you get. And he's from the South, but his last time I looked, Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana was part of the United States of America. So let's give with Dr. Willie Wilson. WillieWilson2016.com. Give us a hand. You won't be disappointed.
And remember, you heard it right here first on the Higher Learning Network. And thanks for watching.
We still believe.
We still believe.
Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network.
Hi, my name is State Senator Ricky Hendon, and you're watching the Higher Learning Network.
Jane, you are so pretty, girl.
Thank
Make
you.
Us four-finger sisters look good.
So why are you here today? What brought you here?
Actually, I come out here a lot for book signings, but okay. I really liked her book. I read it. It was encouraging and whatever.
You read it already?
Yeah, I got it a few weeks ago. So.
Okay. Have you read Shalomith Books, Inspirational Conversations, 365 Days from Promise? Comes on Troy Tyler every day at 10:45.
Was Elder Robinson?
Yeah.
Yeah, I
have
sure
you read
have.
That?
Yeah, it's
good
on my bookshelf.
Yeah. Is it really?
Yeah.
Where'd you get it from?
Afrocentric.
Did you? Good for you. I'm going to introduce you to her when we get in here, okay?
Right.
Yeah,
okay.
So let's come on in. We're calling in the book.
We're going to see Monique. Us big girls, you know, we got our own fan club.
By the way, have you ever met Zelda? Do you know who she is?
No, I've never met her.
You're talking to her.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Are you just for a special conversation with
Zelda? Yeah, you see, I got my book, girl.
Let me get a shake hand.
Come on, sister.
Okay.
We're getting ready to have some fun, girl.
Join the Higher Learning Network at our new time. Tuesdays at 6 p.m. on Channel 19.
Willie Wilson 2016.
Thank you very much.
Yes. And we appreciate everybody coming. Again, God bless you all, and God bless this great country, America.
Latifah, and you're watching ZTV on the Higher Learning Network.